Is he looking?
Settings?
Checking.
It's you.
It's virtually me anyway. There you are. Hi.
Hi.
You're cute.
Really?
Yeah. That's your cue.
My pardon?
Cute.
Right, no, nice. I mean, you look nice. Very nice.
Better than the chat room, huh?
Yeah.
Well, it's almost midnight here. I better get to bed.
Okay, then.
Can't wait to see you again. Oh, okay. Good night.
Hey, Bark.
Better be a grass skirt under that desk.
Hawaiian Day is optional.
Well, here, take one of mine. You give those to girls if they show you their tits.
That's Mardi Gras Bark.
Well, apparently nobody told Tina in accounting that, huh? Who's the chick?
It's Kelly. It's my girlfriend.
You're funny. Get out. You and her. How long you been seeing each other?
3 months.
3 months? And Bark wasn't introduced?
She's in Newfoundland.
Newfoundland? How'd you meet?
On the net. God.
The net? Oh, you poor deluded son. You think this is really her picture? She may not even really be a she.
Bark, you're an idiot. We met on webcam, okay? Now, I have a lot of work to do.
You're the idiot, all right? And you never met her in real life. Not in the world of 100% pure beef. Hmm? So what do you really know? Only what she wants you to know.
I met a trucker named Kelly once. Thank you.
You know, you should get some higher bandwidth, then you wouldn't be so jittery.
I think I've got something better than higher bandwidth.
Oh?
I got accepted into the Langley Cookie Academy.
Oh.
In Vancouver.
Oh. Wow. That's great. Where will you stay?
Actually, I was kind of hoping I could stay with you. Just for a week or so, till I find a place of my own.
Of course. Absolutely.
Are you sure?
Are you kidding? I can't wait to see you.
Live. In the flesh. Okay, I gotta go. I'll email you the details.
Yes!
Hey. I just read that in Newfoundland a 300-pound tattooed deviant was paroled, and he's coming to see you.
It's not gonna work, Bark. I've met her. I've seen her. I know her.
Fred, the internet is like one worldwide witness relocation program. Everybody trying to create new identities for themselves because the ones they were born with aren't working.
Kelly is fine. There's nothing wrong with Kelly.
Okay. Let's just say, just for argument's sake, that she is all that. You've still got a lose-lose situation on your hands, bro. What does she know about you?
Plenty.
Yeah, she knows just what you've told her, and God knows what you've told her.
I haven't lied to her.
No? Well, then she knows you're bilingual? English and Klingon? Or does she know you work for a glamorous IT company and data entry? Does she know about the brain? Oh, yeah. This chick totally knows what she's gotten herself into.
Sorry, baby, you just can't stay here. Don't look at me like that. It's only for a little while. You could just tell her that I had to leave town. Suddenly, I got transferred.
Wait. You're leaving town? Who's paying the rent?
Well, I'm not actually leaving.
You're not leaving?
No, I'll be here.
But you want me to tell her that you're not here?
Yes.
Even though you are?
Yes.
Oh. Do you see this?
Yes, I do.
This was my mother's. She gave this to me to remind me of all the value she taught me. Do you think she would want me to lie?
To save someone's life?
The life of a liar?
Okay, then.
And don't you think of skipping out. I know your social insurance number.
Thank you.
329.
Thank you.
630.
Friday night is the 80s night. I'm gonna get you on that dance floor.
I was in my 30s in the 80s.
Not for the whole thing.
What are my favorite shows on tomorrow night?
We can tape Queer Eye for the Straight Guy. I meant Will and Grace.
Hey,
Kelly, were you knocking? I was, in the shower. How'd you get in?
You're even cuter in person. Good pizza pocket.
Thanks. I think in the future all food will be in pocket form.
Oh. Oh God. I'm
no,
so
that's okay.
Clumsy.
That's okay.
Look at TV. Is that an Xbox?
Oh, yeah, I borrowed it from a friend.
Oh, it's not yours.
Well, it's more mine than his, I suppose.
Is that what I think it is?
Dead or Alive 3, you like that?
Do I?
You're pretty good. You know, I'm creating my own game right now. I got a few level creators off the net.
I kicked your ass.
You did. You kicked my ass.
So, what are you gonna do about it?
I'm gonna make you a snack.
Only if it's in pocket form. I'll get my bags out of the way.
I thought you could sleep on the futon. I even have some DOA sheets. Kelly?
Is that a brain?
So she wasn't thrilled with the brain?
I don't know if it was the brain or the jar or that the brain was floating in the jar or...
Well, you explained it to her, right? You let her know it was just some movie memorabilia?
It's not just some movie memorabilia. It's the brain from Alien Mind Probe. It cost me $800 US on eBay.
And she wasn't impressed.
She was a little freaked out.
Yeah, I don't think women get the whole brain in the jar thing.
Why is that? It represents the epitome of human technology, the ability to take our consciousness outside ourselves and put it anywhere.
Yeah, so long as you stay in the jar. Come on, man, when was the last time you saw a jarred brain pick up a real hot-looking babe? Fred, my friend, my buddy, my pal, real women are dirty, filthy animals. If you're lucky, and you can learn to love that.
Kelly keeps knocking things over.
She's probably just nervous.
The apartment shakes when she blows her nose.
Sinus irritation from a long flight.
She laughs like Francis the Talking Mule.
I can put a damper on things.
Kelly?
Hi, Fred.
Is everything okay?
Oh, yeah. I don't think it's as bad as it looks. What the...
Jesus Christ! How can something be burnt and frozen? Oh.
I think there's something wrong with the stove. More pizza pocket?
No, thanks. It's delicious.
Just wanted to make a nice dinner to say thanks for letting me stay here for a while.
I appreciate the thought, really.
Not very good in the kitchen.
Well, I guess that's why you've come here. Go to cooking school.
Yeah.
Listen, I hope the brain didn't...
Oh, come on.
I should have introduced you or
surprise, that's all.
Well, I'm glad.
Fred, I don't get the brain in the jar.
It's a prop from...
Alien Mind Probe? You mentioned that.
I don't think girls get the floating brain thing. See, it represents the epitome of human achievement.
Didn't the Egyptians put brains in jars over 3,000 years ago?
But not the consciousness. Not their awareness.
That's what the hieroglyphs are for.
You don't understand.
The brain in the jar is like using technology to free us from our bodies and allows us to project ourselves anywhere in space.
Yes.
Sort of like the internet without all the typing.
Yes.
Yeah. I don't get it.
Yes, yes you do.
No, because for me the good of the technology isn't escaping our bodies. It's allowing us to connect with other bodies. You up for a little video game action?
Sure.
Oh yeah, you think so? Take this, baby.
Wow. All right. Just come a little closer, Tina Armstrong. A little closer.
You're not gonna get me that easily.
Oh. Aha! I am the victor. I am victorious. I am Victor Victorious.
Yeah, well, you're going down in real time.
Pardon?
That's right, girly man. Tina Armstrong is calling you out. Big man. Lord of the Yellow Bellies.
Hold on now.
King of the Scaredy Cats.
I warn you, Tina Armstrong, mistress of the Soggy Bottom. Your time is nigh.
Armstrong, waist hold.
Bay man, Pantyang. Pantyang. Victory is mine.
Never.
Oh, watch out, Kelly. Joe, please.
Bayman is frightened. His idol is threatened. That was close.
Could you just stay away from the jar, please, Kelly? Could you stop laughing, please? You sound like a fucking mule.
You are defeated.
Oh, God. I'm sorry.
A mule?
So you blew it.
I didn't blow it. I made a mistake. I misspoke.
Right, yeah, misspoke. Which is French for blew it. Oh, come on, what's the big deal? It's not like you really liked her anyway, right?
What are you talking about? Of course I liked her. I like her.
Yeah. But not really. I mean, let's face it, you had a couple shots at it and you sabotaged them.
What?
Anytime you get a woman all hot and bothered and then you start insulting her, that's sabotage. So she bumps into some stuff, has a laugh. You think you can afford to be so picky? I mean, have you looked at yourself?
So what, you think I just gotta take what's handed to me? You think I don't have the right to someone...
Perfect?
Perfect for me.
Ooh, I don't think she exists, pal.
I'm not your pal.
Hey, don't get assy with me, bro. I'm just trying to help.
Yeah, how? Because if there's anyone on this planet who knows even less about women than me, it's you, pal.
All I'm saying is if I had the chance, I'd pick the real live one over the picture every time.
Thanks for letting me stay here.
You're going?
Yeah. I thought, there's this girl in my class. She's looking for a roommate. She's got a two-bedroom, so I think it's gonna work out just great.
Don't go.
No, I'm gonna go. Thanks so much. I mean, we're practically strangers, and you...
Don't go.
You hurt me, Fred.
I know. I'm sorry.
There are guys who'd be willing to go to Jupiter and back for a girl with a laugh like mine.
I know there are.
What good does it do either one of us if you're not one of them? Not everybody likes everyone. It's nobody's fault.
But I do. I do like you.
You like my image. You seem to like me at a distance. But really, that's hardly me at all.